Citizen Television.
And welcome to another episode of the Planetary Persuader. I am your host, Cosmic Kev, and this is for the week beginning with Friday, the 14th of September, going all the way to the 21st. Now, what's special about this week? Well, we got a new moon, folks. A new moon is always a new chance and a new beginning. And this new moon is happening on Saturday the 15th, 7:31 p.m. Pacific Daylight Time. And so there we are in Virgo, in the middle of Virgo. And Virgo is, its key phrase as I analyze, it's symbolic of the Virgin. And some pictures of it have her with a shaft of grains. We associate Virgo with the harvest. We associate Virgo with agriculture. You know, and here in Northern California, we associate Virgo with being the best time for food because it's the meeting of summer and fall. And so we get, you know, our pears and apples are coming on, and but we also still have melons and plums, and we can even get blueberries from the coast some places. And so it's really, you know, grapes, Concord grapes. Ooh, they're so yummy. So this is all part of the mix of Virgo time. And Virgo is sometimes thought to be prudish. And one of the words that we use to describe Virgo is discriminating. And so, and of course, when Pluto was in Virgo in the late 50s through the early 70s, discrimination was a naughty word, you know, and it was like that was, but discrimination is not always bad because sometimes you need to be discriminating. I mean, discrimination against a race or a religious group or people's, you know, cultural preferences, you know, or bedroom positions or whatever. It's like, you know, that's not good. But, you know, being discriminating about what you eat, you know, like junk food versus real food, hey, that stuff is important, you know, otherwise you're going to end up killing yourself or cheating yourself out of a long, healthy life. So we have to be thankful that Virgo often has a strength to renounce bad things in their diet, you know, and more than any other sign. And I hear it's a sign that enjoys, you know, being in the buff the most, likes being naked. My younger brother's a Virgo, and he really liked to grovel around in the dirt a lot. And I want to say happy birthday, Mikey, because today's his birthday. 48 years old, you're the dragon, an amazing guy in every way, thoughtful being, and I'm proud of him. This guy, no, he swims. Talk about health. The dude swims 3 miles, like, every day. I mean, that is intense, you know? And he's built like a tank, you know? He's not all skinny like me, you know? He's like, whoa, it's impressive. And he does ocean swims, and so, you know, this is my thing. And he's got a lovely wife and two boys, two almost teenagers, and doing it, teenage boys, and so Virgo, this is your deal, you know, this is our deal. It's like we got to celebrate the harvest and we have to learn how to be discriminating, all of us, in our own Virgo ways. You know, you don't have to have your son in Virgo. Everybody got Virgo in their chart somewhere, and this is what's being activated right now. So, live long and prosper. And what I'd say the message is, be critically thankful. Find things that are critically praiseworthy. There is no need to be a downer. We can uplift. In fact, the perfection is really that nature is perfection, and that all we have to do is, I wouldn't say go with the flow, because sometimes that implies stupidity, but to allow nature to reveal the best time to do the best things.